I'll take the next couple of minutes to try to have more of a perhaps a conversation about an issue that poll after poll shows is certainly the number one issue on the minds of voters this year, both in the presidential race and in all the statewide races, and that of course is jobs and the economy. And so I want to ask each of you what your plan is to bring more jobs into the state, and we've been pretty lucky here in New Hampshire with an unemployment rate that's lower than the national average, but yet people are still looking for good quality jobs. And so I want to start with Mrs. Cilley, I believe. Is that right? Yes, Mrs. Cilley.
Thank you. There is no magic formula to job creation. We know because the businesses have told us they need a well-educated workforce. That's why Albany International came to Rochester, a district that I served, and brought 400 jobs with them. That's why, you know, another company moved from Canada to Littleton with 200 jobs. We know they want a well-educated workforce. We know they need good roads and good bridges to bring their products over. We know they need a good transportation infrastructure. You know, I'm from Berlin and the North Country. You can spend time up there, and there are very few places that your smarter than smartphone actually works. So we know that, and we know they want safe and healthy communities. And we are dropping on all of the ratings that, you know, because we're not making the investments that we need to make in those very things that businesses want to bring good jobs to our citizens. So that's, it's not a magic formula, but that's what it is.
Maggie Hassan?
Well, a recent CNBC poll showed that our economic standing has dropped from somewhere around 10th to 34th because of cuts this legislature made to our university system and to infrastructure spending. So the first thing we have to do is stop the Tea Party and take the corner office so that we can do the kind of planning and work we need to do to increase our economy, improve it. I have an Innovate New Hampshire Jobs Plan that focuses on partnering with our educators, particularly restoring the cuts to the university system, and in exchange for that, freezing tuition so college will be more affordable. We also want to make sure that we invest in targeted tax credits, like the research and development tax credit that I sponsored as a senator and I think is appropriate to double, and then to make sure we're working with our educators to give the kind of technological assistance to our businesses that they need to thrive and grow, especially important in a state with so many small businesses, especially important up in the North Country, where that kind of technological assistance could make all the difference.
Mr. Kennedy.
I think we have a lot of the positive attributes to attract business. We have good quality of life. We have good infrastructure, reasonable good infrastructure. I agree that we lack some of the essentials up north, like communication, better roads, better bridges. But the other issues we need to look at are the things that deter businesses from coming here, and especially small business. And those are the regressive property tax. That's a deterrent. Utility rates, which is one of the highest in New England. Business enterprise tax, business profit tax, LLC tax. I mean, I can go on. Those are deterrents to bringing in the smaller enterprises into this state. We can always bring in the BAEs and all the big corporations because they're backed by government contracts and things like that. But we have to do what's right infrastructure-wise and tax-wise to bring the smaller businesses into the state.
Jackie, there's a lot of talk about improving education as a way to bring jobs back to New Hampshire. As a follow-up to what Ms. Hassan had to say, where do you get the money now to get improve education in New Hampshire?
Well, as I said at the very beginning, we need to look at how we're resourcing government as it is. If we want to make that commitment, if we want our tuition rates to come down for our students, if we want a vibrant university system that produces the next generation of workers, we absolutely have to reinstate that money, and we have to make a commitment to them. You know, education took me out of poverty. It's done so for thousands of our citizens, and it's given them a different life. It certainly has given me a different life. So that's a commitment that we absolutely have to find the resources to do.
Maggie, your response to where do we find the money for education?
Well, the first thing we have to do is focus on growing the economy. I want to make sure that we have the best workforce in the country, because when you do that, businesses from around the country will come to New Hampshire to start and will stay here to grow. And so you make sure that you're looking at growing the economy, the revenues that will grow with that, as they've already begun to grow as our economy recovers. Then you also look at restoring a number of the tax cuts that this legislature put in place. They cut the cigarette tax while also cutting the university system budget by half. They might as well have said to our young people, study less, smoke more. And then you make sure you look at some of the back of the budget tax cuts that they did as well. And you work hard also to look at government efficiencies and savings so that we can make sure that we are investing in our priorities. It's always hard whenever you're making a budget to find the money you need. But that's why you need leaders who share your priorities so that you can make sure your values are represented in the budget.
Bill Kennedy, your ideas for finding money for education.
In a down economy, we're losing funding. That's obvious. And Maggie talks about growing the economy. In a down economy, you're not growing. So you need revenue from somewhere. And where is that revenue going to come? It's going to come in the form of a tax. I do not want a higher tax. I do not want a higher tax for our people. What I want is a fair and equitable tax that is broad-based, that has everybody engaged, that is reasonable, rational, and right. And that revenue can be derived by a fair tax. And I'm a proponent, as everybody knows, for a fair income, flat rate income tax. Thank you.